Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi allazina astafa. Amma ba'd, fa'a'uzu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِن رَّحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ: يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فإني أتوب إليه في اليوم 100 مرة، أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في شأن حبيبه ومحبوبه مخبرا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه وسلم. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه وسلم. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحابه وسلم. بلغ العلا بكماله، كشف الدجى بجماله، حسنت جميع خصاله، صلوا عليه وآله. مجھے کچھ ملے یا نہ ملے، محمد ملے یا نہ شيء جسے اللہ ملے. بلغ العلا بكماله، كشف الدجى بجماله، حسنت جميع خصاله، صلوا عليه وآله. یہ تیری معراج کی تو لوح قلم تیرے ہے، اور میرے معراج ہے کہ میں تیری قدم تک پہنچا ہے. بلغ العلا بکماله، کشف الدجا بجماله، حسنت جميع خصاله، صلوا عليه وآله. الآخر 24 Live World News Facebook page presents. I'm here to say a few words about one of the beautiful topic, which is the importance of Tawbah. First of all, I like to give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gave me power and ability to come here to say a few words in front of my respected viewers of 24 Live World News. I like to give you thanks who join to me, who are watching this blessed program. Insha'Allah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me power, I will try to stay here, try to say a few words about 1 hour, inshallah. I would like to request everyone, please like this program, put your beautiful comment in comment box, and share this blessed program so that the other people can be able to watch this blessed and important program. Brothers and sisters who are watching this program, let's praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by pronouncing the beautiful word of praise and thanks, Alhamdulillah. Now I would like to send a lot of blessings and peace, durood and salam, upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is taking relax in Madina Sharif and who is still crying by saying, Ya Ummati, Ya Ummati. He can watch, he can observe our activities. As he is the last and final messenger, he is the messenger of all messengers. He is the prophet of all prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named him by saying Habibullah, the most lovable, the most favorite prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't create his prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wouldn't create the sky, the earth, the heaven, the hell. Even he didn't create anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a prophet who is a complete prophet. His character, his ideology is the best of all mankind. People should follow his characteristics, his ideology. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. O people, I sent a prophet in his life. You have best ideology. The best ideology for those people who believe in Allah, who believe in afterlife, and who remember Allah's name in a great deal, many times. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the greatest of all prophets and messengers. So we should pronounce the word of shukr, Alhamdulillah, every moment, every time. Alhamdulillah is one of the most favorite words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are four words are very favorite to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. So this is one of the best zikr, best tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now I am going to my topic straight away. Today's topic is the importance of Tawbah, repentance, to seek forgiveness. What is the meaning of Tawbah? Tawbah, this is the Arabic word. It means to come back. It means to remember previous sins. It means to seek forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone has sins. Somebody have big sins. Somebody has small sins. Somebody might commit sins secretly. And someone might commit sins openly. But every man has sins. Undoubtedly, as we are the children of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, so this is very common for us to commit sins. To commit sins, this is normal matter. This is not great problem. The problem is, after committing sins, if we don't seek forgiveness, if we don't repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the great sins. Our father, father of mankind, Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, he is the first prophet in this world. He committed sins unwillingly. The devil misguided him. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid him not to go to the forbidden tree, but he went there. He ate fruit of forbidden tree. This was his mistake. So as we are the children of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, this is very common matter to commit sins. But after committing sins, if we seek forgiveness, if we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we make tawbah by saying, "Oh Allah, forgive our previous sins," then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our all kind of sins, insha'Allah. We have to make tawbah. And this tawbah has some conditions. I'm going to explain one after one, insha'Allah. Please stay with me. Before that, I see some of comments which I should recite, which I should read out. Shottir Pratibadi, he gave me salam, saying assalamu alaikum, wa alaikum salam. He said marhaba, marhaba. Shamsul Islam, the honorable and respected founder of the page 24 Live World News. Brother Shamsul Islam, he is watching our program from Jeddah. And he wrote, mashallah, London theke Mawlana Fakhrul Islam Sahib Tawbar Fazilat ni alochona korchen, shobai share korben please. Thank you, my dear brother. He wrote, majhe moddhe banglate bolben jonab, oneke bujhte parben, Allah pak hayate barkat dan korun, duniya akherate aro beshi sommanito korun. Amin, inshallah. I'll try to say some words in Bangla. To ami je kotha boltechi seta hocche amra Adam sontan, Adam alaihissalamer sontan, Adam alaihissalam শয়তানের প্ররোচনায় পড়ে একটা মিস্টেক করেছিলেন, ভুল করেছিলেন, সেটা ইচ্ছাই করেননি, সেটা ছিল পদস্খলন। ওনার সন্তান হিসাবে আমাদের ভুল থাকবে, অপরাধ থাকবে, গুনাহ থাকবে, কেউ প্রকাশ্যে করেন, কেউ গোপনে করেন, কারো বড় গুনাহ রয়েছে, কারো ছোট গুনাহ রয়েছে, কেউ শিরক করছেন, কেউ বিদআত করছেন, কেউ গোপনে করছেন, কিন্তু গুনাহ অবশ্যই আছে, কারো কম কারো বেশি, গুনাহ করাটা স্বাভাবিক। কিন্তু গুনাহ করার পরে যদি আমরা তওবা না করি, সেটা হচ্ছে মারাত্মক অপরাধ। আদম আলাইহিসসালামের ভুল ছিল, কিন্তু আল্লাহর কাছে তিনি তওবা করেছেন, ক্ষমা চেয়েছেন, এই জন্য আল্লাহ পাক তাকে মাফ করে তার নবী হিসাবে কবুল করে নিয়েছেন। কিন্তু ইবলিস শয়তান সেও ভুল করেছিল, অপরাধ করেছিল, আর তার অপরাধ ছিল গ্রেট মিস্টেক, কবিরা গুনার মধ্যে অন্যতম একটি গুনাহ। সে অহংকার করেছিল, আল্লাহ পাকের কমান্ড সে অস্বীকার করেছিল। অপরাধ করার পরে যদি সে যদি আদম আলাইহিসসালামের মতো তওবা করত, আল্লাহ পাক তাকে মাফ করে দিতেন। কিন্তু সে তওবা করে নাই, বরং অহংকার করেছে, যুক্তি দেখিয়েছে, আমি কেন আদমকে সেজদা করব, বিকজ আই এম গ্রেটার দেন আদম, আমি আদম থেকে বড়। ইউ ক্রিয়েটেড আদম ফ্রম সয়েল, ইউ ক্রিয়েটেড মি ফ্রম ফায়ার, সো ফায়ার ইজ গ্রেটার দেন সয়েল, সো হাউ ক্যান আই গিভ সিজদা টু আদম আলাইহিসসালাতু ওয়াসসালাম। অহংকার করেছিল বিদায়। আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা এই মুআল্লিমুল মালাইকা যাকে বলা হতো, সারা জমিনের সব জায়গায় যে ব্যক্তি সেজদা করেছে একটি মাত্র অপরাধের কারণে, আল্লাহ পাক তাকে জান্নাত থেকে বের করে দিয়েছেন, এবং কেয়ামত পর্যন্ত তার গলায় লানতের শৃঙ্খল থাকবে। বন্ধুরা আমার, ভাইয়েরা আমার, এখান থেকে ক্লিয়ার হয়ে গিয়েছে, উই শুড মেক তাওবা, উই শুড মেক রিপেন্টেন্স, উই শুড সিক ফরগিভনেস to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us tawfeeq. I am reading some of more comments. Aba Hussain Joblu, brother, wrote Mashallah. Sayyid Mia wrote Mashallah. Shottir Pratinidhi wrote Mohan Allah apnar nek hayat dan kurun amin. Thank you, my dear brother. Abdul Shukur is watching our program from London. He wrote Mashallah. Ahmad Hussain Choudhury, Sri Mongoli, he wrote Alhamdulillah onek onek shubhechha roilo. Thank you, my dear brother. Anwar Ahmed, one of my friends, he's watching our program. Mufti Abdul Majid, Pirispuri, Bangladesh theke amader program dekhchen. He wrote Shukran. Oneke amader program dekhchen and they put their beautiful comments, beautiful opinions. Mashallah, may Allah bless you. May Allah bless you and give you beautiful rewards here and hereafter. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Habib Khan, one of Islamic thinkers, alim, speakers. He wrote, Mashallah. Shaheen Mia wrote, Mashallah. Mashallah, your comments, basically your comments, your opinions, encourage me to say more few words. Inshallah. My dear brothers and sisters who are watching this blessed program, I am going to say about my topic, that is the importance of Tawbah. We should make Tawbah. Every prophet, every messenger, they did Tawbah in their life. Though they have no sins, but their Tawbah means it was the lesson for their followers. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make Tawbah every day more than 70 times. I am saying a hadith which has been mentioned in Sahih Bukhari Sharif. One Abi Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Wallahi inni la astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayhi fil yawm aksar min 70 marrah. One of beautiful hadith. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wallahi, by Allah, swearing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Inni la astaghfirullah, undoubtedly, I seek forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa atubi ilayh, and I repent to Him, fil yawm, in every day, aksar min 70 marrah, more than 70 times, subhanallah. As our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make tawbah every day more than 70 times. So what can we understand from this hadith? We have to make tawbah every day, many times. We have to cry for our previous sins. Jehetu doyal nobiji pratidin 70 barer upore tawbah korten. Arekti hadithe dekhlam tini 100 bar pratidin tawbah korten. Tini tar ummatderke khoman korechen bolechen ya ayyuhan nas o you who believed o mankind ya ayyuhan nas tubu ila Allah repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fa inni atubu ila Allah fil yawmi 100 marrah undoubtedly surely, I repent every day to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 100 times. Bishwanabi, pratidin 100 bar tini tawbah korten, subhanallah. Jar kuno aparad chilo na, jar kuno guna chilo na. Allah pak nabi ke khoma chawar jonne khoman korechen. Tawbar jonne adesh diyechen. Nabi ji ke adesh diyechen, nabi ji tawbah korechen, khoma cheyechen. Keno? নিজের জন্য নয়, তার উম্মতের জন্য। এর জবাব হচ্ছে দুটি, একটা হচ্ছে he seek forgiveness for his followers so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive his followers previous sins, and the another reason is so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can increase his ranks in his life in Jannah. Duniyay ebong jannate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala যাতে তার বন্ধুর র্যাঙ্কস বাড়িয়ে দেন, পদমর্যাদা বৃদ্ধি করে দেন, এই জন্য আল্লাহর নবীজি তওবা করেছেন, ইস্তেগফার করেছেন। অনেকেই আবার মিস অ্যানালাইজ করে, মিস এক্সপ্লেইন করে এই আয়াতের উপরে ভিত্তি করে, যে আয়াতটা সূরা নাসরের মধ্যে রয়েছে। আল্লাহ পাক বলেছেন, إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. When the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his victory will come, then you will see the people are accepting Islam in groups. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ. So glorify the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Glorify the name of your Lord. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ. And seek forgiveness to him. إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Some so-called scholars, they misexplained by this word wastagfirhu. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned here, the word wastagfirhu, it means Prophet committed sins in his life, na'uzubillah. But we believe, the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat, all prophets and messengers are ma'asum, sinless. They have no any minor sins, major sins. They are like ma'asum. They are like newborn children. They have no sins. So what is the explanation of the word wastaghfir? It means seek forgiveness. Seek forgiveness for your followers. Seek forgiveness for increasing your ranks. Brothers and sisters, so if we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the benefit? What is the fayda? What is the credit in our life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Nuh, when Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam invited his people, he invited his people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night time, daytime, secretly, openly. He invited people about 950 years, but only 80 people accepted his religion, accepted his da'wat. He invited his people by saying, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. O my people, seek forgiveness to your Lord. Undoubtedly, he is Ghaffar, he is forgiver, he is the most merciful. He can forgive your all kind of sins. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. If you seek forgiveness, you have a lot of benefits, lot of rewards. First benefit, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. He will send mercy and blessings from the sky upon you. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. And he will increase in you by wealth and by people. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. And he will give you Jannah, gardens, heaven, paradise. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. And he will give you streams, nahar. সুতরাং এই তিনটি আয়াত থেকে আমাদের কাছে পরিষ্কার হয়ে গিয়েছে, যদি আমরা তওবা করি আমাদের চারটি লাভ। এক নম্বর লাভ হচ্ছে আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন আকাশ থেকে রহমতের বৃষ্টি নাজিল করবেন, আমাদেরকে রহমত বরকত দিয়ে ভরপুর করবেন। তিনি আমাদেরকে জান্নাত দিবেন, তিনি আমাদেরকে নহর দিবেন, তিনি আমাদের জীবনের সমস্ত গুনাহ মাফ করে দিবেন এবং দনে জনে ভরপুর করে দিবেন। সুবহানাল্লাহ। ব্রাদার্স এন্ড সিস্টার্স, আই উড লাইক টু গিভ ইউ এ লট অফ থ্যাংকস অ্যাজ ইউ আর ওয়াচিং আওয়ার প্রোগ্রাম অ্যান্ড কমেন্টিং হিয়ার বিউটিফুলি। সত্যের প্রতিবাদী রট সুবহানাল্লাহ, সুবহানাল্লাহ। আবুল হুসাইন রট মাশাল্লাহ, জাযাকাল্লাহ খাইরান ফিদ্দারাইন। মে আল্লাহ ব্লেস ইউ হিয়ার অ্যান্ড হিয়ার আফটার। আমিন ইয়া রাব্বাল আলামিন। নাও আই এম সেইং another verse from Quranul Kareem where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the benefits of Tawbah. If we commit sins a lot, even like mountains, even like all the stars in the sky, even like all the drops of water, of seas. Though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our every kind of sins if we make tawbah proper way. If we make tawbah from our hearts. If we make tawbah following some of conditions which have been described by ulama-i-karam. Ulama-i-karam said, Tawbah-i-Naswa has some conditions. First condition, when we'll make tawbah, we have to remember all of our previous sins. Second condition, when we'll make tawbah, we have to try to cry. If we can't cry proper way, at least we should pretend to cry. The third condition is, when we'll make tawbah, we have to remember our sins and we have to take oath, we have to promise that we'll never commit such kind of sins in our future life. So, if we make tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our all kind of previous sins. He will make us like newborn children, newborn baby. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, At-ta'ib min az-zambi kamal la zambala. At-ta'ib, the one who makes tawbah. At-ta'ib min az-zambi kamal la zambala. The one who makes tawbah from his sins, he will be like newborn baby who has no any kind of sins. Bishwa Nabi Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guruttopurno hadith tini bolechen tawbakarir obostha emon hoye jay attaibu minaz zambi guna theke tawbakari emon hoye jay kamalla zambala mone hoy jeno tar jibone ekta guna o nai. Subhanallah, subhanallah. I'm saying another hadith. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Kull bani Adam khatta wa khayrul khatta'in at-tawwabun. Every child of Adam alayhi salam is sinner. Every child of Adam alayhi salam can commit sins. This is very common matter. Because devil is every time trying to misguide us. Every time trying us to make any kind of sin. Devil is our great enemy. We have to stay away from devil. We have to keep a long distance from devil. He is not our friend. He is our enemy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu dkhulu fis-silm kaffa wa la tattabi'u khutuwatish-shaytan innahu lakum aduwwun mubin. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O believers, O you who believed, udkhulu fis-silm kaffa, enter into Islam completely, fully. This is not good for us to perform some of from Islam and some of from another religion. That is not allowed. We have to enter into Islam completely. This is command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا قُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ, and don't follow the footsteps of devils. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. Undoubtedly, he is your clear enemy, great enemy. So devil doesn't want good for us. He every time, every moment wants bad for us. He every time tries us to misguide us, to show us bad path. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us every time to right path. So this is our responsibility. This is our duty to accept the invitation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our responsibilities to accept the invitations of all prophets and messengers. This is our duties to follow the ideology of Quran and Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one of the hadith which has been delivered by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his last sermon, he said, لَقَدْ تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ أَمْرَيْنِ لَنْ تَضِلُّوا مَا تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَسُنَّةَ رَسُولِهِ. I left in you two things. If you hold them first, if you hold them strongly, you will never be misguided. First one is Kitabullah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, undoubtedly Quranul Kareem. Another one is Sunnatu Rasulillah, the ideology of the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these two things, why we are misguided now? Why we are dishonored, disrespected, insulted in present world? Why? The main reason is we are very far from the ideology of Quran and Sunnah. We have chosen the bad path in this life. That's why Muslims are misguided. That's why Muslims are dishonored. That's why Muslims are disrespected by the people of another religion. So brothers, please come in one platform. Come and hold the ideology of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Quran al-Kareem. He said, Khayrul kalami kalamullah wa khayrul hadi hadi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best kalam is the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is Quranul Kareem. And the best guidance is the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These two things are sufficient for us. We should follow them. We should recite Quranul Kareem with meaning, try to understand it, and try to utilize the rules and regulations of Quranul Kareem in our private life, family life, social life, political life. InshaAllah, peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come soon. We will be victory again. InshaAllah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. وَفِي آيَةٍ أُخْرَى قَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَاللَّهُ مُتِمُّ نُورِهِ وَلَوْ كَرِهَ الْكَافِرُونَ. The people of another religion, they want to put out the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their one blow. Wallahu mutimmu nuri. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill his light, will complete his light. Walau karihal kafirun. Though the unbelievers don't like it. It is like that. So we are very glad, we are very successful that we have become the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we should follow the instructions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you committed a lot of sins, make tawbah. Do tawbah and nasuha. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you like newborn children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Zumar, verse 53, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, O my servants, O my slaves, those of you who did unjust upon themselves, la taqnatu min rahmatillah, don't be hopeless from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the verse about the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the verse about the greatest mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't be hopeless from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O duniyar manushera, jodi pahar puriman guna koru, shagorer fena puriman guna koru, duniyar somosto gaspalar patash somo puriman guna tumader take. La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't be hopeless from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah pakir rahmat teke nirash hoye jayona. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Undoubtedly, He will forgive your all kind of sins. Innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Indeed, He is the most merciful and He is the most forgiver. আল্লাহ পাক দয়ালু, আল্লাহ পাক ক্ষমাশীল। আমরা আল্লাহর কাছে চাইব, আল্লাহর কাছে কাঁদব, আমরা তৌবায় নাসোহা করব। এই তৌবায় নাসোহা করলে কি লাভ, এ সম্পর্কে সূরা তাহরিমে আল্লাহ পাক ঘোষণা দিয়েছেন, ইয়া আইয়ুহাল্লাযীনা আমানু তুবু ইলাল্লাহি তাওবাতান নাসুহা আসা রাব্বুকুম আন ইউকাফফিরা আনকুম সাইয়্যাতিকুম ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, O you who believed, Tubu ila Allah tawbatan nasuha. Make tawbah. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with tawbatan nasuha. What is tawbah nasuha? The tawbah which should be performed with sincerity, with heart. The tawbah which can come from our hearts, which has three or four conditions. These are already described by me. So if we make tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Asa rabbukum an yukaffira ankum sayyi'atikum. First benefit, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your all kind of previous sins. Wa yudkhilakum jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar. And He will allow you to enter into Jannah. Under it, the streams will flow. Ditiyo lab hoche, tini amon ekta jannate dukar onumoti amader ke diben, je jannater tolodeshe nohor shomo probahito thakbe. Titiyo lab holo, yawma la yughzillahun nabiyya wallazina amanu ma'ah. That day of judgment, day of recompense, He will never dishonor His Prophet and those who are with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuruhum yas'a bayna aydihim wa bi aymanihim. The lights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will run all around of the believing people at the day of judgment. Yaquluna rabbana atmim lana nurana waghfir lana. And that day, the believing people, the believers, men and women, will make dua by saying, Rabbana atmim lana nurana waghfir lana. Oh Lord, please, kindly complete our lights and forgive us. Waghfir lana, innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. Surely, you are the most powerful over everything. So from this beautiful verse, we can understand we should make tawbah, which is called tawbah nasuha, and we will be able to get a lot of rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even at the day of judgment, we will be able to stay with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase in our ranks at the day of judgment, in heaven, in paradise. Brothers and sisters, so every time we should seek forgiveness, we should make dua, we should glorify Allah's name, we should read dua by saying, Allahumma hasibni hisaba yaseera, wa Allah, wa Lord, please take our hisab, take our account very easily, very easy way. Don't take our account very hard. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna batusha rabbika la shadid. Indeed, Allah's grasp, Allah's holding is very strict, which is unbearable. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes our account very strongly, very hard, we'll have no way to rescue, to flee away from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, we should make tawbah in time. We have to think every moment of our life is the last and final moment. Because we don't know when the angel of death will come to us and will take our souls away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed Malakul Maut Azrail alayhi salatu was salam to take souls away from the hearts of people, from the body of people. But we don't know when it's going to be happened. So every time might be our last moment. Every moment might be our last moment, last stage. Now I am speaking, you can hear. But after finishing my lecture, after finishing my speech, I might go to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, we should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He is the most merciful. He is the acceptor of tawbah. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Allah yabsutu yadahu billayl liyatuba musi'an nahar. Wa yabsutu yadahu bin nahar liyatuba musi'an layl. Hatta tatlu'u shamsu min maghribiha. Surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends His hands at night time for forgiving those servants who commit sins at daytime. And He extends His hands in daytime for forgiving His servants who commit sins at night time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every time is calling His servants, Please come to my path. Please come to the path of light, path of paradise, path of Jannah. Please come to me, accept my invitation, seek forgiveness to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes so happy upon those servants who seek forgiveness, who make tawbah. So if we want to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy and satisfied upon us, we should try to make tawbah every moment. We should remember our previous sins. We should perform good amal, good deeds in life. Everyone knows this life is temporary. This life is going to be finished very soon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kullu man alayha fan wa yabqa wajhu rabbika zul jalali wal ikram. Everything and everybody is going to be destroyed on this land very soon. Except the one who is the owner of honor and respect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm saying a story which has been happened at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from this story, you will be able to easily understand how powerful and what is the benefit of tawbah. What is the significance of tawbah? At the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a woman came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him, Ya Rasulullah, I committed big sins by doing adultery. I committed adultery. When our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard the word adultery, that means zina, baby child, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned his face to his right side. The woman, went her right side and told him again, Ya Rasulullah, I committed adultery. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned his face left side. The lady went his left side and told him again, Ya Rasulullah, I committed sins. I committed adultery and I became pregnant. Please apply the punishment according to Quran and Sunnah, according Islamic law. In that time, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his head and looked at her and told her, you committed sins, but your child who is coming soon, your child didn't commit sins. So in this time, I can't apply punishment upon you. Because you committed sins, your child didn't commit. So come back later when your child will be born. The lady went back. And she was thinking and thinking. She was thinking that the punishment of the world is very little, very minor. But the punishment of Jahannam, which is unbearable, which is very strict. When his child was born, the lady came back to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his newborn baby and told, Ya Rasulullah, I came back to you with my child. Please apply punishment upon me according to Islamic Sharia. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her again, you committed sins, but Your newborn child didn't commit sins. He has rights upon you. He has to drink milk from your breast about 2.5 years. So come back when your child will stop drinking milk from your breast. The lady came back. The lady went back to her area. And after 2.5 years, when his child stopped drinking milk from her breast, he came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and requested him, Ya Rasulullah, please apply punishment upon me according to Quran Sunnah, as I committed sins, as I committed adultery. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded his companions, Sahaba Ikaram Ridwanullahu alayhim ajma'in, to give her punishment, make a hole, make her enter into it, and throw stones on her head. Sahaba Ikaram did what our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded them. Sahaba Ikaram started throwing stones on her head. The blood is spreading out. One drop of blood touched one of Sahaba Ikaram and he started using bad words. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, O my Sahabi, don't abuse her. Don't use bad words about her. Because she made a Tawbah, which is Tawbah Nasuha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted her Tawbah the way if we want to distribute her Tawbah upon all of the mankind in this world, this Tawbah can be divided in same way. Same division. So if we make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our all kind of sins. Undoubtedly, He is the most merciful. He is Tawwab. He is Rahim. He is Ghafoor. So brothers and sisters, my respected viewers, I think those who are listening to my speech, who are listening to my words, it is very clear to you, to make sins, to commit sins, this is very common for us. This is not problem. The problem is, after committing sins, if we don't make tawbah, this is the great mistake. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us every time to make tawbah. Even he taught us the Sayyidul Istighfar. Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa ant. Khalaqtani wa ana abduk. Wa ana ala ahdik. Wa wa'dika ma istata'tu. A'udhu bika min sharri ma sanatu. Abu'u laka bi ni'matika alayya. Wa abu'u bi zambi. فَغْفِرْ لِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الزُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. এর নাম হচ্ছে সাইয়্যিদুল ইস্তিগফার. এই ইস্তিগফার পড়ার চেষ্টা করবেন, একটু লম্বা, কিন্তু আপনি গুগলে সার্চ দিলে পেয়ে যাবেন ইনশাআল্লাহ, এবং মুখস্থ করার চেষ্টা করবেন. এই সাইয়্যিদুল ইস্তিগফার যারা তেলাওয়াত করবে, আল্লাহর নবীজি ঘোষণা দিয়েছেন, পাহাড় পরিমাণ গুনাহ থাকলেও আল্লাহ পাক তাদেরকে মাফ করে দিবেন. সুবহানাল্লাহ. How can we make tawbah? What are the words of tawbah? Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us, taught us by saying, we have to read 3 times astaghfirullah after finishing every 4th prayer. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Inna Allah ghafoorur raheem. Astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayhi. Wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah. Whenever we have free time, we get time, we'll try to read these. These are the words of Tawbah. May Allah accept our speech. May Allah accept all of us as His righteous slaves, righteous servants. May Allah accept our program and give us rewards here and hereafter. Every time we should make Tawbah, every time we should make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I am reading some of more comments. Mawlana Amenur, who is watching our program from Bangladesh, he wrote, Mashallah, who is the respected principal of Mustafa Fur Alim Madrasa. May Allah bless him, give him rewards here and hereafter. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Askar ei program theke amader shikha newa uchit. Amra joto boro gunagar hoi na keno, Allah paker kache jodi amra tauba kori, istighfar kori, Allah pak amaderke khoma kore diben. May Allah bless all of us. May Allah forgive all of our previous sins, big sins, small sins, minor sins, major sins, open sins, secret sins. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Bhalo takun, shusto takun, stay away and stay well, keep safe. May Allah save us from coronavirus. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.